2,000 years after the departure of Jesus Christ. The prophets are back to teach the real Jews, the 12 tribes of Israel, their true nationality. This is their campaign.
God of this Bible. Give me Psalm 66 and 15. Psalm 66 and 15. What's your nationality, brother?
I'm from the motherland. That's me.
What is the motherland?
Africa.
Yeah, see? You're off. You don't know where you're from. Where in Africa you from?
I don't know.
Exactly. You ain't no African.
Where you from?
You're an Israelite.
Where you from?
I'm an Israelite.
No, first of all, Israelite.
I'm an Israelite.
Israel is
you
the name
don't
of a
know
man.
Where you're from,
Israel
brother.
Is the name of a man.
Now,
where was Jacob
question.
From? And where
I'll
was his father
question.
From? And his father.
Ask, what African customs do you keep?
Abraham was from Iraq.
Ask you a question. What African
are
customs?
Are you Babylonian?
I ask you a question. What African customs do you keep?
And his mother was
see,
Egyptian.
Fake, see that? You are a fake African. You ain't a real African.
Bro,
you're a silly Negro Israelite in the ghettos of the South Bronx. That's what
right.
you are.
And what are you again?
15. Psalm chapter 66,
that's the
verse 15.
Gotta come
I will up.
Verse 1.
I'm not
intelligent.
You're disrespecting me by speaking right now because I'm speaking. I'm trying to teach.
You asked me a question, brother.
Psalm chapter 66, verse 5. Come and see the works of God.
Sister, you want the answer? I'm going to give you the answer.
I want to know.
All right,
that,
so he asked the question
right?
first.
Well, the only real
I thought you wasn't
come,
talking.
Come closer. Sister,
yeah?
Come closer. I'm going to answer you. Say it again on the mic. Say it again. Come closer.
Jesus Christ, the Son of God. That's the real God.
And what's your point with telling? What's the point in telling me that?
No, why you ain't telling she wrong? That's
that?
Wrong.
This is back up. I'm gonna tell you. Do you want to? You want an answer, or you're gonna leave without getting the answer, sister? What's the answer? You don't know.
You
I'm gonna tell you why.
You read the Bible. She gonna be confused.
This is why she does not want the answer. She has white Jesus in her brain. She got the white man set up.
You got black
so,
Jesus.
When this comes out, this is offensive to the lies that she's been taught. Catholicism. Roman Catholicism. That trash. That's what this promotes right here. It promotes hatred. That's why she can't stand to get the answer in the truth. But we're going to get the answer in the truth. Read what you got first.
So they be done with the boss?
1 second.
Because that ain't saying nothing about the boss.
1 second. The book of Psalms, chapter 66. I said, 1 second. Can you wait, brother?
You're asleep.
See that? See, listen. You brothers are so emotional. You can't even wait. Brother, be respectful. Be respectful. I'm reading something. This is our form, not yours. This is our form. I can do that because if I want to do it, I can. So be quiet until I'm ready to talk to you.
Yeah, black white man.
The book of Psalms, chapter 66, verse 5. Come and see the works of God.
So the scripture says, come and see the works of God. Good.
He is terrible.
No, he's nice.
He is terrible.
He is terrible to who?
In his doings toward the children of men.
See that? He is terrible with his doings towards the children of men. That's you blacks and Hispanics in the ghettos of America today, man. You're at the bottom. Getting shot, selling drugs, getting murdered by the cops and your own brothers. And you got the nerve to come here and talk to me about some trash about divorce. What's your nationality?
My nationality present day, I'm American.
American.
Where do you come from?
I just told you.
You come from America.
I come from Africa.
Where in Africa do you come from?
I haven't done my genealogy yet.
So give me the genealogy. Give me the science.
Hold on, no. You can't give me the genealogy
yet.
The only way to move and find the genealogy is we'll go through directly through history. Because the Byzantine Empire moved the Israelites. The Romans moved the Israelites. the British movie Israelites.
So, you know what? So, are you an Israelite?
Am I an Israelite? I consider myself an Israelite.
Okay, give me numbers 15.
But I can look at some of you brothers here and can do my bone structure.
Wait,
it can't be Israelite.
First you said you're Israelite.
Come on.
Then you said you're African.
It's the same thing.
You don't make no damn sense.
It's the same thing.
One comes from Ham, one comes from Shem. You cannot be both. So, you're confused.
That's
read.
False.
Now, as an Israelite, you should be keeping God's
Abraham
laws.
Is the father of both.
As an Israelite, you should know why we're at
is
the bottom.
Abraham,
read.
Is Abraham the father of both or not?
No,
I'm
going to
prove it wrong again on camera.
38.
When a person
the book
who
of Numbers, chapter 15, verse 38.
Can't do it.
Speak unto the children of Israel. So you said you're the children of Israel, right?
Yes, I am.
Good. And bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments. Do what? B-I-D.
I'm not sure. What context is it using here? I'm not sure. Bid me.
It means to command. Command them.
Okay.
Do you read it again? And bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments. Command them that they make fringes in the borders of their garments. This is a simple law here that an Israelite should be keeping. Read. Throughout their generations. Are we still generating? Yes, the hell we are. So you're supposed to have fringes on your clothes. Read. And that they put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue. That's why every last one of these brothers you see fringes, border blue. Read. No fringes. Because guess what? As an Israelite, you should be keeping God's laws. That's why we're at
That's
the bottom
law.
Now.
That's not a law.
Read it again. Read 37. Numbers chapter 15, verse 37. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel. The children of Israel. And bid them. And what? And bid them. And what? And bid them. The word means command them. It's a commandment, brother. That's a law. Command them what? That they make them fringes in the borders of their garments. That's a law, brother. You're wrong again. Wrong. Good. Throughout their generations. Now, can you admit you're wrong?
See, am I wrong?
That's the pride. That's the pride of the black man right there.
I'm not wrong.
Hold on, I said, when the brother corrected me, I said that's wrong. Let me elaborate. The brother says, no, I'm wrong. I can't be wrong. Let me elaborate.
There you go. Is that in the 600 plus laws that God commanded?
Yes.
Is that part of the 600 laws?
Yes.
That's the first
thing. No.
The book of Numbers. That's the first five books called the Torah. The law. Read. Verse 37. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, so once again, brother, you're wrong. Speak unto the children of Israel and bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments. So every last one of the Israelites, your true culture is to wear fringes in the borders of your garments.
That's right.
Look like the damn white man. Not look like the fascists of the world. That's what you do. You look like everybody else.
Throughout
their generations, and that they put upon the face of the borders a ribbon of blue. A ribbon of blue. So where's your fringes? You don't got them. You're in the midst of sin, brother. Read. And it shall be unto you for a fringe. Read. That ye may look upon it. Now, here's the purpose of, I hope you're listening, brother. Here's the purpose of the fringe. Read. That ye may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord. And what? And do them. And remember, this is the purpose of the fringe, brother. To remember the commandments of the Lord and to do them. Negroes don't want to do the commandments of the Lord. They want to look like everybody else and blend in with society. No, the scripture says, give me that, Matthew 5:16. The scripture says, you're supposed to let your light shine, brother. You ain't letting no light shine in your pink shirt. You ain't letting nothing shine. Nobody knows if you're an Israelite. You look like everybody else.
Hold on.
Read. The book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 16. Let your light so shine before men. Read it again. Let your light so shine before men. What does that mean, let your light shine before men? What does that mean?
Your knowledge.
Is that it?
Light is enlightenment.
What is knowledge according to the Bible?
Knowledge is your wisdom, and the knowledge of God.
What does that mean?
Your understanding of God's law.
No, there's more to it. What else?
Okay, explain. I don't know. I gave
Deuteronomy
you three things.
Understanding of the
I gave you three things.
And you're wrong. Deuteronomy 4 and 5.
Yeah. So light is not knowledge.
I'm going to get it for you. No, no, give me Proverbs 6:23.
Oh, well.
Let's see what the light is.
You're on camera. You know that, right?
Yeah, you on camera too.
I know that. Light is knowledge.
Read, let's find out what light
all throughout
is.
The Bible.
The book of Proverbs. Let's find out. The book of Proverbs, chapter 6, verse 23. For the commandment is a lamp. The commandment is a lamp. And the law is light. And what? And the law is light. And what? And the law is light. What's the light? The law is light. So the laws of God. And one of the laws of God is to put fringes on your clothes.
That's
now,
right.
Go back to Matthew.
What's your penis got to do with it?
Matthew 5, 16.
Man,
the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 16. Let your light so shine before men. What did the scripture say? Let your light so shine before men. So what's the light? What's the light? What is it?
Nothing can understand it.
The law of God.
Nothing can understand it. The law is what? It's
Matthew
wisdom, isn't 5, it?
5 verse 16.
It is it says the wisdom.
Good.
The law
let
is not
your
the
light so shine before men.
Man,
that
man.
They may see your good works. Hey, brother, let me ask you a question. It says let your light shine before men that men may see your good works. If I got fringes, if I have no fringes on my clothes, how do I, if I don't speak to you and I go by you on the street, do I know you're an Israelite?
So they bring you.
Thank you. So you gotta have fringes on your clothes. That's your true culture.
Yeah.
Fringes on your clothes.
What did Jesus say about the law?
Oh, let's get it. Read the next line. Verse 17. Oh, hey, you, good question.
I have not come
Matthew
to
chapter
5,
law, verse 17.
Nor the prophets. Hey,
listen
up. Fulfill it.
Think not that I am come to destroy the law. Hey, look, brother, the very next verse says what? Think not that I am come to destroy the law. Hey, did Christ have fringes on? Yes, he did. Read it again. Think not that I am come to destroy the law. Hey, the scripture says, Christ said, don't even think I came to destroy the law of fringes. Don't even think about it. I got on fringes. That's what Christ
he
said.
He was talking about fringes?
Read. Yes, he was.
He was talking about fringes.
That's a part
fringes.
Of the law. Yes.
So when he
or the prophets. Or what the prophet said.
What's the most important
I am
commandment?
Not come to destroy. What's the, you tell me.
The most important commandment is to believe in one God with no partners.
What's your point?
You just asked me what I asked you.
Now, I said, what's your point?
That's the most important law.
What's your point? So is fringes a commandment? Yes, it is. Read it again. Matthew chapter 5, verse 17.
You made no sense,
think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. So let's find out what Christ fulfilled. Luke 24, 44. Let's find out. Did Christ fulfill thou shalt not kill? Did Christ fulfill thou shalt not steal? Did Christ fulfill the law of fringes? Let's find out what Christ fulfilled.
What about the Sabbath?
The book, be quiet. You don't know. You're in the midst of sin. Be quiet. The book of Luke, chapter 8. Why don't you repent first? Do that. Then ask questions.
I repent every day.
Read that first. We're going to read.
Read that first. Every day.
The book of Luke, chapter 24, verse 44. But you haven't sincerely repented.
How do you know?
You haven't sincerely repented.
How do you know?
You're still in midst of sin.
How do you know?
I'm telling you. I just told you. You're still in midst of sin.
No.
Go ahead. The book of Luke, chapter 24, verse 44. I just told you the sin you're in. And he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you. Christ said, these are the words which I spake unto you, my disciples, my apostles, God, while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled. All things must be fulfilled, which were written in the law of Moses. All things which were written in the law of Moses, God, and in the prophets, and in the Psalms, concerning me. See that? That's what Christ fulfilled. He did not fulfill the laws of God, and he fulfilled animal sacrifice. Okay? So, once again, you're in the midst of sin. Okay? So you gotta repent. Get repent.
I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.